Right, hello everyone. My name's Simon from Loughborough University. Colleague here, Mike, is helping me with the cameras. What we're going to show you today is a demonstration of a hydrogen fuel cell powering a remote control plane propeller motor combination. But we're not using the commercial off-the-shelf fuel cell controller. We're going to use the Raspberry Pi. So, first of all, what's a fuel cell? Well, a fuel cell is a device, in this instance, that converts hydrogen into electricity. Quite simply, water and heat are some other byproducts as well. So as you can see, we have the fuel cell here. It's not particularly heavy. That weighs less than a kilo. It's 24 cells. And it's rated at 100 watts, and it's the Horizon H100 fuel cell. It comes with a controller, which looks something like that, and this plugs into the fuel cell. It controls all the valves and the fan on it, and makes sure that you're not doing anything stupid in terms of over voltage, over temperature, things like that. But I've taken that off, and being a control engineer, I thought I'd make my own. So, the fuel cell is connected, first of all here, that's the hydrogen line, that's connected to our big bottle of hydrogen outside, and then this is the waste pipe here, just going into that beaker so it doesn't spray my computer full of water, and all that comes out of the back of there is pure water. So, you know, it's quite a green technology as well if you're interested in that sort of thing. Now, how are we controlling it then? Well, down here we have a Raspberry Pi, which I'm sure you Element 14 guys should know what that is, but for anyone watching outside of the Element 14 community, it's a little Linux computer, credit card size, costs around 20 quid, so it's dead cheap, and you can just plug it in and it works. It's brilliant. I've also got some attached devices. So first of all, we have the Pi Face digital I/O board, and what this is, it's a series of inputs and a series of outputs. So this allows you to control digitally using ones and noughts anything that's attached. On the input side, I haven't got anything plugged in, but we are going to be using the buttons. So the buttons change from ground to high, which I think is 5 volts. So this is simply an on-off switch. So the first button there is on and off for the fuel cell, and the second button is a reset. On the outputs then, you'll see there's 4 wires connected. One of them is ground, so that gives us a reference. That doesn't really do anything particularly interesting. But then we've got 3 thicker wires in here. The first one is connected to the hydrogen valve on the fuel cell. So if this is high, it allows hydrogen into the device. The second one is the purge valve. So this allows the water out of the device. You don't want this always on, because you'll end up wasting all your hydrogen out the back, so you let some water build up and then purge every so often. Here we're purging for half a second every 30 seconds. And the final one then is the fan. So there's a fan on the device to blow air through it. For the chemical reactions to occur, you need hydrogen and oxygen. So the more air you can get to it, the more chemical reaction happens effectively, and the more power you get. And also it's quite useful for cooling as well. That's the Pi Face digital I/O. Now, we've got this ribbon cable going straight off the GPIO, the general purpose input-output, onto what's called a Pi rack. That's this. All this is just a breakout board that allows you to have multiple things plugged in at once, rather than it being the leaning tower of Pi going on. It will be nicer when I actually get this set up and it's in a box and it's all screwed down so it's not wobbling about. What we have here, first of all, on the bottom, this is just a breakout board for the I2C bus, and at the moment we have just one device plugged in, and that is a TMP-102 digital temperature sensor. We'll see that working in a moment. Here we have AB Electronics ADC Pi version 2. So this is an 8-channel single-ended ADC. It can read any voltage 0 to 5 volts, and we'll see what this is connected to in a moment. And then on top we have Pi Face's new control and display board, the Pi Face CAD. I'm not actually using any of the controls on it at the moment, but I will be using the display. I've coded something onto there, and we'll show you that working in a moment as well. So I mentioned the ADC is connected to something. It's connected to an Autopilot 180, and all this is a current and voltage monitor, and that tells us whatever's going through these wires, what the voltage is, and the current that is passing through it, so we can monitor what the fuel cell is performing like. So we're going to connect that up to the fuel cell itself. Simple as that. The other end then, the interesting end, is the actual motor. So this is commercial off the shelf, what you'd expect in a remote control plane. We have a receiver. This is receiving the signals that I'm sending it from my transmitter here. Exactly as you would do in a normal RC plane. We have the speed controller, so this converts the DC voltage into three phase, which is required by the brushless motor, and we have a folding prop. So quite a typical setup. If you're familiar with RC stuff, you'll understand. So I'm going to hook that on here, just using crocodile clips for now, which is going to enable me to also put a voltmeter on there so we can verify some of the numbers. Nice and bodge. Make sure that's on. Okay, so turn the voltmeter on. So currently we're at 0 volts, what you would expect. As I mentioned, the fuel cell needs to be controlled in terms of its hydrogen supply, air, purge valve and fan. That's connected to the Raspberry Pi, so we just need to connect the dongle here. And this is what would normally connect to the commercial off-the-shelf controller as well. So, the code then, well, first of all, we've turned the Raspberry Pi on. We've got the normal login screen, as you would expect. So I'm going to log on. I'll say that. There we go. A nice little wireless keyboard here. So we've logged in. I'm going to change my directory to my H100 file. All this code is available on GitHub. It's all open source for you, so for anyone wanting to replicate this, it's all on there, so please feel free to do so. And we'll have just a quick look at the Python code. So, here we go. So it's written in Python 2, but it's using some Python 3 libraries, and it all seems to work quite fine. So we import some libraries, Pyface Digital I.O., Pyface Control and Display Board. It's all pre-written, you don't need to do anything with that. And then I've written a couple of drivers for the ADC, the temperature sensor, the switches and the display board, so it's displaying what I want. And then it's the normal complicated code setup. The way I've written it is it's as a state machine, so the fuel cell can either be on, off, in startup, shutdown, or in an error mode, which will be coded at a later date, so if it's got too hot, producing too many amps, or the voltage is under or over what it should be, we can put it into an error mode just to save the life of the fuel cell. So, what happens when we run the code? That's the more interesting thing. So I'm going to run it here with the command sudo python controller.py. I actually want to save the data, so we've put the functionality on here to save the data to a file. So you put dash dash out and then whatever file you want to call it. So let's call it demo TSV. You can put the whatever extension you like on it, it doesn't matter, but it's tab separated values. So as soon as I hit enter, it should all fire up now. And we get the nice matrix screen. You won't be able to see it, but effectively what we've got is time, the state, the ADC reading, so we've got voltage and current. Those two are unused at the moment. That'll be for when we hybridise the system with the battery. Then we have our temperature. Currently we only have one of the four temperature sensors plugged in. You can almost just see that's about 20 degrees at the moment. And the fuel cell is in the OK state, so it's not hit an error. What we can see then on the control and display board is a nice little quick reference. So it's telling us that we're on the H100 fuel cell. It's currently off. we're at about 20 degrees, so if I put my finger over the temperature sensor, we can see the temperature going up already, so it's pretty quick to respond. The little tab on the end shows you each time the display gets updated. It's running as a separate thread, so it doesn't lag the main code. And currently we've got 0 volts, 0 amps, therefore 0 watts. Probably because that's become unplugged. Okay. So, to run the code, we've got the hydrogen turned on. So we're simply going to press the first button here. You hear some hissing as the fuel cell goes into its startup mode. And what happens is the fan starts spinning, the hydrogen turns on, the purge turns on, that blasts hydrogen through the system just to get rid of any rubbish that's in there, just to keep everything clean, prolonging the life of the fuel cell. And you'll see we are now in the on state. And you will also see that I've got the current sensor plugged in backwards, so let's change that round. Okay, there we go. So non-calibrated at the moment, it's telling us 19 volts. What are we actually getting? 20.7, so we're not far off with the guess calibration that comes with the ADC main code. So a bit of tweaking and that'll be bang on. So how do we actually make something move? Well, first of all, we have the transmitter. Transmitter's on, so again, commercial off the shelf system at this end of the device. And if I just give it some throttle, we should start to see the prop turning. And there we go. So at a reasonably low throttle, we can see the voltage has dropped to about 16.9. Remember, it was at about 20 something before. And as the fuel cell, as the chemical reaction in the fuel cell starts to crank up, we can see the voltage recovering, so we're already 17.2, 17.3, and we'll see that go up until it's happy. It should be lower than the open circuit voltage, but it'll be higher than what it is after that step change in load. So this is one of the fundamental problems, if you like, with the fuel cell. It doesn't do dynamic loads very well, so if you suddenly wanted full power for takeoff, Collins has dropped his spanner. If you wanted full power for takeoff, it's not going to give you full power until you've run that load for a good few seconds. And the quantifying number there, we're not too sure until we've done the testing. With the EH100, I'm expecting it to be 10 to 30 seconds. Some larger fuel cells, for example solid oxide fuel cells, could be hours. So the tradition is to hybridise it, to put it in parallel with the battery. And the battery could receive for that instantaneous load until the fuel cells recover. So, probably stable-ish around 17.7 volts there. If we have a look at the control and display board, it says we're about 17 volts. You can get right in there just so you can make sure we can see it. 1 amp, that's obviously lying. It's certainly more than that, so I'll have to check the calibration. And then it's giving us our wattage there. So, if I give it a little bit more beans, and we watch the voltage as I give it some more juice, you can see the voltage collapse very quickly, much more than you would expect of a battery. And again, if we leave it, the voltage will start recovering as the chemical reaction picks up. Not forgetting, all this data is being saved on the screen, as you can see there, being saved to demo.csv. Or whatever file name we would have given it. So, to shut the system down, first of all we need to kill the throttle. Make sure we can get that in there. That's it, so that's the propeller stopped. We're now back to the almost open circuit voltage very quickly. And I'm going to press the shutdown button on the biface CAD. And when I press this, if we watch the control and display board, you'll see it change from on to shutdown. There we are, so we're into shutdown now. And that goes through the preset shutdown routine, which I think is about 10 seconds at the moment. And now we're off. So we can safely unplug the fuel cell now. There will be a remaining bit of residual electricity in the fuel cell, which I could bleed now.
but it's not very good for the device, so we won't do that. And what will happen, what we'd expect to see if I did do that, would be the voltage will collapse to zero and not recover.
So, we've now cancelled the
post,
so that's stopped running. On my laptop then, completely wireless, we can connect to the FTP server of the Raspberry Pi, so I can download the data. So I'm just using FileZilla here, choose any FTP server you want. Go into the H100 directory, get right in close so you can see this.
And as you can see there, we've got the controller.py, so that was the program that we were running. And here we have demo.tsv. So if I can open that, it downloads it direct from the device, so this will be as live as you can get it. And excuse it being in Notepad, which is a bit rubbish for the word wrap. Let's turn word wrap off. Oh, I didn't change it too much, but you can see the data there is what we saw on the screen, which if you remember was time, the state, so on, off, shutdown, standby. Then you add the ADC reading, so your voltage and your current. Then you add your temperature, and then you add a little statement at the end just to say that the fuel cell was okay and hadn't gone into an error shutdown.
So, for future work then, what we're going to look at is, first of all, we're going to tune all the sensors up so we know that the voltage and the current that it's reading are bang on. And I will make those numbers available. Don't forget, if you are replicating the system, you'll need to make your own fine tuning, because each device will be slightly different. We're also going to look at removing the tether. So currently, the only tether we've got is this one, which is the hydrogen supply. And we're going to replace that with some hydro sticks. So these are metal hydride stores, and each one will store 12 litres of hydrogen gas. So we'll need a few of these just to get it all running, but this will then be a complete system we'll require to get us into the air. We'll also get the other temperature sensors working, and we'll look at getting the hybrid set up. So that'll be linking the fuel cell with a battery such that we've got that instantaneous power that we need for takeoff, and we've also got the capability of recharging that battery in flight using the fuel cell, so we don't need to carry a big battery to last us the entire flight. We can carry a lighter, smaller battery, which gives us more room for payload or more room for hydrogen for long enduring stuff. So look forward to that next time.